Our next speaker needs no introduction. Lord Tariq, Ahmad of Wimbledon, who is currently the Under Secretary of State and Ministers for Communities at the Department of Communities and Local Government, appointed in July 2014. Prior to this, he was a government whip and Lord Spokesman in the House of Lords for Science and Universities. He is well known to the community and therefore needs no further introduction. I'd like to call him to come and say a few words.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Beloved Hazur, dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. It is indeed both a great pleasure and honor, but also a point of great humility for me to stand before you today at this august convention. 125 years ago, the promised Messiah, the Mahdi of Islam, laid the foundations of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community across the world. Today, 125 years on, the community has made strides across the world. It is most humbling for me to stand before you today as a minister of Her Majesty's government, as the grandson of a companion of the very promised Messiah, my grandfather, of course, Hazrat Jadi Ali Muhammad Biti Sahib, known to many of you. From those early origins in Qadian, the community and members of the community have flourished from every corner of the globe. In every profession, in every field, you see Ahmadi Muslims excelling, men and women alike, going forward, demonstrating through words, through actions most importantly, what the true Islam, the renaissance of Islam is, which is Ahmadiyyat. Hazur, I know with colleagues across Parliament, indeed across the world, condemned universally the tragic events we've seen across the world of persecution against the Ahmadiyya Jamaat. We reflect, of course, on the tragic assassination of Dr. Mahdi, the killing, the brutal killing of the young girls Kainat and Hira, along with other relatives in Gujranwala. And I assure you that every government, including my own, does not stand back. Representations are made. The strongest condemnations are made. But the most powerful response to this is what our beloved Hazur does. In face of persecution, he says pray. In the face of violence, he preaches peace. And as we've heard from many a colleague across from different governments today, and where we find hate as a community, Hazur and every ambassador of the community across the world preaches love. For this was the way of the holy founder of Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it is that very spirit infused today in the renaissance of Islam, which is Ahmadiyyat. We talk sometimes of symbolism. We talk, can religion and national pride and loyalty to one's nation come together? I point no further often to guests at the Jalsa than just across the way from this very marquee, where you see the standard, the Lawai Ahmadiyyat of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, fluttering high, being respected, being protected. But alongside that is the flag of our country, of the United Kingdom. So when it comes to Ahmadi Muslims, there is no contradiction, there is no conflict. Being proud and devout of one's religion means one's proud and loyal to one's nation. So my dear brothers and sisters, my beloved Hazur, let me assure you that my government does take the issues that the Ahmadiyya Jamaat presents very seriously. It recognizes across the board the services of the community, as we've heard from Mary and others alike, that the Jamaat makes in the charitable sector. I know many were touched, for example, when the hundreds of thousands of pounds raised right here in the UK for UK-based charities. But as we look across the world of Islam today, we see extremism. We see fanaticism. Is that the Islam? Of course not. The Islam that we see today is the Islam which is practiced by the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, which our beloved Hazur has taken to every corner of this globe. In conclusion, if I may, Hazur, present the Prime Minister's message, who writes that he sends his best wishes to the Jalsa Salana. I want to send my best wishes to everyone taking part in this year's Jalsa Salana. I know how incredibly important this gathering is for Ahmadi Muslims in the United Kingdom and indeed around the world. And therefore, I praise you all for coming together in such a positive way to both reject extremism and indeed to pray for peace. I would also like to take this opportunity to congratulate His Holiness and the worldwide Ahmadiyya community as you celebrate 125 years since your establishment. In that time, the community has worked tirelessly to help bring faiths and people together in the name of unity, harmony, and peace. So on this special occasion, on behalf of my government, I wish to send you all a very joyous and peaceful Jalsa. The Right Honourable David Cameron, Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Hazur, Jazakum Allah, it's been a great opportunity for me and a humbling opportunity to address the Jalsa once again. And I ask you most humbly to pray for me in the work I'm undertaking to ensure that what the community does in terms of its work across the world continues to receive not just the attention, but also people recognize that the Ahmadi Muslim community stands primarily and foremost for humanity. Jazakumullah.
Nara Takbir! Islam Ahmadiyyat! Shohadae Ahmadiyyat! Asirane Rahimola! Nara Takbir!
Jazakumullah.